Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Dandabad Pranams.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, Dandabad Pranam.
Hare Krishna, Dandabad Pranams.
How are you, Guru Maharaj?
I'm okay. How are you?
Yes, I am fine, Guru Maharaj. Thank you.
So you share those slokas, you can share them with Mitravinda.
Okay, I will share our Guru Maharaj.
Those are the memorization slokas for Bhakti Shastri.
Okay, Guru Maharaj. 35 slokas.
Yeah, there's more. The first four verses of Upadeshamrita.
Okay.
And then the first two verses of Ishopanishad. The invocation and mantra one, Ishopanishad. And then there's four from the nectar of devotion.
From first chapter there is no sloka. It is start from two chapter.
Yeah, that's for the Bhakti Shastri. But you could learn the first verse. Everybody should know the first verse of the Bhagavad Gita. It's a very important verse.
Okay.
Everybody should learn that. Okay, we can begin.
Yes, Maharaji.
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vanchakaupata Rubyastya Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the prayers offered by Prahlad Maharaj to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narsingadev. Right? Lord Narsingadev had killed Prahlad's father, but Prahlad is still offering prayers to him.
Narsingadev jo hununcha Prahlad Maharaj ka pita ko hatya garne hununcha te pani Prahlad Maharaj le aile yaha Narsingadev ko prarthana gardai hununcha.
So in the last class we heard Prahlad Maharaj talk about how materialistic people are very fond of sex. So now Prahlad Maharaj is describing there are different ways by which one can get liberation.
Right?
One of them is to practice monavrat, being silent. So some people, they think this is very good if you can control, if you don't speak to anybody, you're just silent all the time, you don't say anything. They think this is very advanced, very spiritual. Of course, it's not easy to control the tongue. But even this idea of silence, to be silent, not to make any sound. You know, somebody may just. This is a little different. There are two principles. One is being silent, and the other hand, and some people make a vow not to speak to anybody. So somebody, they may not speak to anybody, but they may still make a lot of noise. And some people, they just want to be quiet. They go away from everyone. They just want to sit alone and be and they enjoy. They think silence. This is very spiritual. But Prabhupada explained, Prabhupada said, real silence is the chanting of Hare Krishna mantra. Just to stop talking, that is not spiritual. Because in the mind there may be so many thoughts, so many desires for sense gratification. I used to do life membership. We used to enroll life members, and I was doing life membership in Calcutta, and I met this one Indian life member, and he told me he made a vow every Sunday he did not speak to anybody. He took a vow of silence, complete silence. But all the other days of the week, Monday to Saturday, he would talk a lot, all the time. He's on the phone, he's talking to customers, talking to people working in his office. Then he goes home, he talks to the family. And so he's talking a lot, but Sunday he wouldn't talk. So that's very temporary renunciation. That is not actual real renunciation. Real renunciation has to be in relation to Krishna. Rupa Goswami describes, Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yukta Vairagya Uchate. Real renunciation is Yukta Vairagya, means in relationship to Krishna.
Asali vairagi ji ki uta banagiri, amiru bhagwan sanga judam, sabpe judnu, bhagwan sanga judam.
So controlling the tongue, the urge to speak, it's a very strong desire. It's described vacho vegam, vacha, the words, and vega, the urge. We all have a strong urge. We like to speak. We like to be heard.
Vacho vegam go, yo boli ko veg jo huncha telai samyam garna ko lagi ekdam garo cha tara jale samyam garcha to ekdam tapas ek mahano.
I'm living here in Mayapur, and in Mayapur, all around us, there are many jackals in the forest. And every night, so every night you can hear the jackals. They make a lot of noise. In the daytime, they're very quiet. They don't do anything. But at night, wow, they make a lot of sound. And similarly, the frogs also, they make a lot of sound. When there's heavy rain, after the heavy rain, you hear the frogs. Prabhupada describes, he said, the frogs are croaking and they're just calling the snake to come and eat them. Because the croaking of the frog attracts the snake. And for the snake, the frog is food. So the croaking of the frog is calling the snake of death. The snake means death to the frog. In the same way, everybody who is using the tongue, who is not speaking about Krishna, they are also calling death to come. In Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami describes, as the sun rises and sets, it reduces the duration of life for anybody who does not talk about the Supreme Lord. So for people who have difficulty to control the senses, it's a very powerful purification for them if they can observe silence. Those of you who are married men, you know how difficult it is for your wife. Could your wife ever be silent? Your wife, they always talk. Women love to talk. So very difficult for a woman to observe silence, to control the tongue. So they have to learn how to become devotee of Krishna. They have to learn how to chant the holy name. They like to talk, so let them chant. Use the tongue to chant.
ल उनीहरु बोल्न चाहन्छन् र उनीहरुले बोल्नको त्यसलाई केमा परिवर्तन गर्नु भन्दाखेरि जपमा परिवर्तन गर्छन्।
They cannot be quiet, they cannot do monavrat. Let them chant japa, let them chant the holy names.
उनीहरु चुपचाप लागेर बस्न सक्दैन भने उनीहरुलाई भगवानको नाम जप गर्न लगाउनु पर्छ।
So this is Prahlad Maharaj is describing there are 10 different processes by which one can become purified.
Prahlad Maharaj le yaha hamile prastut gardai hununcha ki 10 prakar ka vidhi haru.
Because we know not everybody can chant the holy name, not everybody can do 16 rounds every day.
Ra hamile thaha cha ki pratyek vyakti le sadai 16 mala jap garna sakdaina, sadai jap garna bhyaudainan.
Not everybody is a devotee. So there are other processes for people to become advanced in spiritual life, not just only bhakti, there are other processes.
Right.
So one of the processes is to be silent, not to speak to anyone. Then another process is to observe vows. We see in this age, Kali Yuga, it's very hard for people to keep their vows. Just like when people get married, they make vows to protect each other, husband and wife. Although they make vows, they fight and then they divorce. And we get people coming to Krishna consciousness, they also make vows.
But we
see many of them, many people who take the vows, they don't keep the vows. So there are different vows we can take, just like Chaturmasya is a vow. Some people make the vow to observe Chaturmasya. And some people make a vow to observe the Damodar Vrat. Some people may make a vow to recite Bhagavad Gita every day. Somebody may make a vow to go and visit holy places. And so, if you do these things, it's purifying, you can make spiritual advancement. So another way we can do it is by studying all different kinds of Vedic knowledge. Right, you study the Shastras, just like Bhagavad Gita. It's a Shastra, you study the Bhagavad Gita, you can make advancement.
र हामीले अर्कोतिर शास्त्रको अध्ययन गरौँ जस्तो प्रकारले भगवद्गीता अध्ययन गर्नले हामीहरू आध्यात्मिक मार्गमा अग्रसर हुन्छ।
And some people may just study the Shruti, meaning the four Vedas. They may study the Upanishads, for example. That is part of the four Vedas.
र कोही कोहीहरूले उपनिषदहरू अध्ययन गर्छन्। उपनिषदहरू के हुन्छन् त भन्दाखेरि वेदका अङ्गहरू हुन्।
There's a class of people, they only accept the Shruti, they won't accept the Smriti, they won't accept the Puranas, they won't accept Mahabharat.
Mm. पुराण महाभारतहरु उनीहरुले लिदैनन्
they will say no this puranas mahabharat this is not eternal knowledge this is not from god the four vedas they're from god
ra उनीहरुले भन्छन् यो पुराणहरु भगवान सिद्धबाट आएको हैन यो वेदहरु मात्रै भगवान सिद्ध आएको भनेर उनीहरुले त्यो वेदहरुको मात्रै अध्ययन गर्दछन्
So some people they are Vedantists. They only accept the four Vedas. They don't accept any other scriptures.
कोई कोई एक वेदांतिस बनने उन्चन तिनेरे ये चार वेद लेमतर लेन्चन और शास्त्र लाग उन्दरे लेन्ना.
So we have to also know that we have to also know the Vedas. We have to also know the scriptures from the Shruti.
रा हमरे यो है ना कि वेदला मात्रे तेला मात्रे जानने है ना वेदला पनी जानना पड़ता है और श्रुति प्रमाण नगला पनी जानना पड़ता
है ऑफ कोर्स वी डोंट जस्ट ओनली नो द श्रुति वी आल्सो नो द स्मृति
श्रुति मात्रे जानने है ना स्मृति पनी जानना पड़ता
है स्मृति मींस महाभारत द पुराणस
श्रुति को मतलब हो महाभारत पुराण तीरलाई स्मृति भनिन्छ
And Srimad Bhagavatam is also Puranas, so there's also Smriti. So we have, there are people who they just study scriptures and they learn a lot of knowledge. That's very powerful, purifying.
ज्ञान बहुत अध्ययन गर्छन् उनीहरु एकदम शक्तिशाली हुन्छन् आध्यात्मिक ज्ञानमा
एन्ड देन देयर अदर पीपल दे डु अस्टेरिटीज दे विल एक्सेप्ट डिफरेंट अस्टेरिटीज
र कोही कोहीहरु ठुल्ठुलो तपस्या गर्छन् उनीहरुले तपस्याद्वारा अभ्यास गर्छन्
जस्ट लाइक आफ्टर कार्तिक देन वी हैव द कत्यायन व्रत इज वेयर द यंग गर्ल्स दे वर्शिप Katyayani to get a good husband.
Kartik sakira tyani de Katyayani vrata bhane vrata bhane auncha tyo Katyayani vrata yuvati harle garchan yuvati bhaneka taruni harle garchan kina ta bhanakari ramro pati paam bhanera
and they will do things like take their bath in the Yamuna very early in the morning
Katyayani vrata le nagari unharu bihanai sabere uthera Yamuna ma snan garna parcha
And we know just now, this time of the year, it's very cold early in the morning. So it's an austerity to do that. Some people do austerities, they control the eating. They will take only food one time a day. So there are different austerities people do to purify their existence.
Ra manisharu nana prakar ka tapasya haru garchan jasto aflai matlab kun tapasya le aflai ruchi huncha.
And then some people they do things like follow the duties of varnashram dharma.
Ra koi koi byakti haru आफ्नो कर्तव्य पालन गर्नको लागि उनीहरुले वर्णाश्रम धर्म पालन गर्छन्
राइट जस्ट लाइक समबडी इज अ ब्रह्मचारी ही ह्यास टु डु ऑल द ड्युटीज अफ द ब्रह्मचारी
र कोही कोही ब्रह्मचारी हुन्छन् उले ब्रह्मचारीको नियम पूरा पालन गर्नुपर्छ
सम पीपल थिंक ब्रह्मचारी मीन्स समबडी हु इज नॉट मैरिड
र कोही कोहीले सोच्छन् ब्रह्मचारी भनेको कोही अविवाहित व्यक्तिलाई ब्रह्मचारी भनिन्छ भनेर भन्ने सोच्छन्
But brahmachari means somebody who lives in the ashram of the guru. He doesn't just live at home with his mother and father. He has to go out from the house and live with the guru.
Ra brahmachari bhaneko u brahmachari ashram bhane guru ko adhin ma hunu parcha ghar ma mata pita sang basnu hudaina.
Now he has to get trained because brahmachari means one who is on the path of Brahman.
Ra brahmachari bhaneko ब्रह्मान प्राप्त गर्ने मार्गमा भएको हुन्छ
इफ समबडी लिव्स एट होम एन्ड दे हैव अ जॉब इवन दो दे आर नॉट मैरिड दे आर नॉट ब्रह्मचारी
र जो व्यक्ति घरमा बसेको हुन्छ अनि घर यता
Brahmachari doesn't have a job. He doesn't go to work in the factory or work in the office or in the shop. The business of the brahmachari is to study the scriptures. And he will go out and beg, and whatever he collects when he goes begging, he will bring back and give to his guru. So brahmachari doesn't keep his own bank account. And it said brahmachari will not take food unless the guru calls him to come and eat. So there are different duties of the brahmachari. And then grihasthas, they also have the duties, they have different duties to perform. They have to do things like when they prepare food. Then they call out, is anybody hungry? If anybody is hungry, come to our home, food is ready, come and take food with us. We read in Srimad Bhagavatam about great kings like Runti Dev. Runti Dev, when people would come to his home, he would give them all the food he had prepared for his family. He would give it to the guests. Yeah, when the guest comes to the home, we think this is a god coming to our home, and we respect them. And so it's the duty of grihasthas that they bring guests to their home and they feed them. And then the vanaprastha, those who are retired from family life, their duty is to do austerity. They will go to visit holy places and associate with the holy people there in the holy places. And then the sannyasi, their duty is to preach, to travel and preach. And to depend on Krishna, not to be afraid of the of any material situation, but to depend on Krishna. So doing the different duties of one's different ashram is very good for us. It helps us to purify ourselves. Then another process we can do to purify ourselves is to explain the scriptures, explain the knowledge in the scriptures. This is very nice for all devotees to preach Krishna consciousness, to study scriptures, and then whatever we've learned, we try to explain it to people. Lord Chaitanya used to say, he used to quote the verse, Bharata Bhumiti Haila Manushya Janmaja Janma Sartaka Karikara Paroupakar. That people who are born in Bharatvars are very fortunate. They should make themselves perfect, and then they should make others perfect.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le yanara Maharaj le agi shlok ucharan gardinu bhayo ho to shlok ma ke bhanuncha bhanakari jasko bharat bhumi ma janma bhako cha tyo le apno janma sarthak garnu ra sath sathai aru lai pani aru ko janma pani sarthak garaunu.
So we encourage people, read these books, read this Bhagavad Gita, the Srimad Bhagavatam, and then try to explain it, try to share it with other people. Then another process, Prahlad Maharaj says, he said, you can stay in a solitary place, go to a place away from the world, just go on your own and stay there. In the past, people would do like that. When they retired from their material life, then when they took the vanaprastha, they would go away from the world into the forest. We read in Srimad Bhagavatam about Bharat Maharaj. He was a king, emperor of the world. Then he retired when he was still a young man, and he went away to the mountains. He went into the Himalayas. So he was staying up in the Himalayas beside the Ganduki, where the Ganduki river flows, where all the Shalagram Shilas are. So, of course, he got problems because he was alone. He didn't have any association. Somehow he got deviated from his meditation and he became attached to a deer. But still, go to a place, a solitary place, go away from everyone and everything, and just concentrate on spiritual life. That is a great test of our spiritual advancement, how much we can tolerate. Unless one is very advanced, one will be disturbed. He will not be able to tolerate.
जसलाई आध्यात्मिक उन्नति भएको हुन्न उसले हर चीज सहन सक्दैन, जो सहन सक्छ ऊ आध्यात्मिक मार्गमा एकदम उन्नत भएको हुन्छ।
And then another process which we can do for our purification is to chant mantras.
अर्को विधि के हो त भन्दाखेरि हामीले आफै आफूलाई शुद्धिकरण गर्नको लागि हामीले के गर्नुपर्छ त भन्दाखेरि मन्त्र जप गर्नुपर्छ।
Now some people that mentions here actually said chant mantras silently. People like to chant the mantra in their mind, they don't chant it out loud.
कोहीले हामीलाई सुझाव दिन्छन् कि मन्त्र जप गरेको त एकदम मनमन भित्र जप गर्नुपर्छ, उच्च स्वर बाहिर निकालेर जप गर्ने मन्त्र होइन भन्छ।
So we say with chanting Hare Krishna, the louder you chant, the more powerful it becomes.
हामीहरू भन्छौँ जति उच्च स्वरले महामन्त्र जप गर्छ त्यति हामीलाई
We don't encourage people to chant Hare Krishna mantra silently because their mind is not very controlled. We sometimes people come and they're chant. They say they're chanting, they're very silent. They say, oh, I'm chanting in my mind. But actually to chant in the mind is very, very difficult unless you're very advanced. You cannot chant in the mind. Now Haridas Thakur, he was made the Nam Acharya, he's the Acharya of the chanting of the holy names. He was given that position by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Haridas Thakur lai Nam Acharya ko pad prapta bhayeko cha, tyo pad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le pradan garnu bhayeko.
And he used to chant the names very loud.
Haridas Thakur le Bhagwan ko naam ekdam uchcha swar le jap garnu huncho.
People would complain, the brahmanas would complain, why you have to chant so loud? But Haridas Thakur would say, well, if I just chant in my mind, it's good for me, but there's no benefit to anybody else. But when I chant loud, everyone who hears me, they all benefit. So he said, somebody, they feed only one person. They maintain themselves, they just eat food themselves. But there are other people, when they cook for many people and they distribute the food to many people. So who's better? Somebody just feeds himself or somebody who feeds many people? So better you can feed many people than just feed yourself. So loud chanting is better than the silent chanting. And then Prahlad Maharaj said some people, they like to be absorbed in trance. So some people, they will do meditation and they will go into trance, they will stop, close their eyes and they go into meditation, their consciousness goes away from here and they're only conscious within.
Ra koi vyakti ru tap garda kari apno swas आफ्नो चेतना मात्रै उनीहरूलाई थाहा छ अरु अरु के पनि थाहा छैन.
Just like if you do some Ashtanga yoga, the goal of Ashtanga yoga, the final, the eighth step of Ashtanga yoga is samadhi. So samadhi means trance, means fixed mind. The mind is very fixed.
Ashtanga yoga bhaneko eight prakarko yoga huncha. Tesko antim shreni ke euta bhandakheri man lai kendrit garnu.
So some people pretend they're in trance, but they're not really in trance. Some people cheat. In the times of Lord Chaitanya, some yogis would come and they would sit on the bank of the Ganges and they would sit and meditate and they would go into trance.
चैतन्य महाप्रभुको टाइममा कोही कोही व्यक्तिहरू गङ्गाको तटमा आएर बसेर तप गर्थे, ध्यान बस्थे, त्यतिखेर उनीहरू तपमा लिन हुन्थे.
And Lord Chaitanya would come, he'd pick up water from the Ganga and throw it on them, and he'd tell them, get up and chant Hare Krishna.
त्यतिखेर चैतन्य महाप्रभु गङ्गा जल उचालेर उनीहरूलाई छापिदिनुहुन्थ्यो र उठ भन्नुहुन्थ्यो.
So Prahlad Maharaj is describing these different processes. There's about 10 different ways which they can all help to purify people.
Prahlad Maharaj le hamile 10 alag alag paddhati sikaunu huncha jun paddhati dwara hamiru shuddhata ko padma prapta garna sakchhau.
But generally these processes are only for people who cannot control their senses. And some often people they will do these things just to get respect from other people. So that means they're cheaters. They're not genuine sadhus, they're cheaters. Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he wrote a poem about such people. He's describing this person who is addressing the mind. He said, what kind of devotee are you? He said, you go and sit in a quiet place, you go away from the world to sit in a quiet place to chant the holy name. But you do it just to get respect from other people. You don't do it to develop your love for Krishna. The purpose, the real purpose of all of our austerities and penances and sacrifice, everything, the real purpose is to develop love for Krishna. Yeah, Srimad Bhagavatam condemns these kind of processes, that these people are just cheating, they're not real sadhus. Right, we call them Markat Vairagya. Markat Vairagya means monkey renunciation.
Markat Vairagya,
People may think, oh, a monkey is very renounced. He's sitting naked. He just lives in the tree. But the monkey's got so many wives and he's got so many, many, many children. And he gives so much trouble to everybody. And so monkeys are not renounced, but people may, foolish people may think, oh, they're very renounced. So we get people like that, people who are, you know, like monkeys. They're living in the tree or they're going naked, but they've got so many material attachments. So the point is, if one cultivates Krishna consciousness, one doesn't have to bother with these different processes. If somebody is doing the Krishna conscious process, the devotional service, then all of these different activities which people are doing, they're all included within devotional service. Devotees, they chant mantras every day. The devotees, they make vows when they do get their initiation. And they study the Shastras all the time. And they're always speaking about Krishna, so they're always quiet. They don't talk any nonsense. Rupa Goswami said, we have to control the urges. Vacho vegam manasa krodha vegam, jiva vegam, mudaropasta vegam, right? The urge to speak, the mind's demands, the actions of anger, and the urge of the tongue and the belly and genitals, they all have to be controlled. So a Krishna conscious devotee, he very easily can conquer all these different urges by engaging fully in Krishna's service. Instead of speaking prajalpa, instead of speaking all the gossip, the devotee only talks about Krishna. And he controls his mind. He doesn't waste his time thinking about material desires, but he keeps his mind busy thinking about how to serve Krishna. He's always thinking how to spread Krishna consciousness. So this way his mind is always controlled. And he's very careful to control anger. In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says three gates to hell, lust, anger, and greed.
Bhagavatam, Amarlai, Varan Gariyoga Chaki, Bhagavan Krishna Bataununja, Bhagavad Gita, तीनवटा द्वार काम क्रोध लोभ हाम्रो नरक का द्वार भनेर
एभ्री सेन पर्सन मस्ट अवॉइड दिस अर्जेस
र प्रत्येक व्यक्ति यी तीनवटा बेगलाई संयम गर्नु पर्छ
So anger and greed, they come from lust. So we have to control lust. And we control that lust by regulating the senses. The senses are like wild animals. We have to starve them. We have to regulate them. We have to beat them. Make them tame. Devotee knows to use his senses for the service of Krishna. If he's not using them for Krishna's service, He withdraws his senses.
र भक्तहरुलाई सबैलाई थाहा छ कि हाम्रो इन्द्रियहरुलाई कसरी संयम गर्ने भनेर भगवान कृष्णको सेवाद्वारा हामीले इन्द्रियहरु संयम गर्नुपर्छ भनेर भक्तहरुलाई सबैलाई थाहा छ.
Just like there's the turtle, he has a big shell on his back and he uses his feet to go walking here and there or swimming. But then when he's not doing anything, he brings everything under the shell. All the senses come, they're withdrawn.
Totari eta uta jancha, hincha, khancha, kuchha. Tara ule kei garena vane ki garcha ta vana kari, uska indriya ru kutta ar sape vidra ulcha.
So this way devotee learns to control his mind and senses.
र यो प्रकारले भक्तहरूले के सिक्नु पर्छ भन्दाखेरि कसरी हाम्रा इन्द्रियहरूलाई संयम गर्ने भनेर
He will only eat Krishna prasadam and he will not eat too much.
र उसले कृष्ण प्रसाद मात्रै खान्छु भनेर र धेरै पनि खान्न भनेर
And he will not put too much weight on the belly.
र उ पेटमा धेरै वजन दाल्दिन भनेर त्यसरी खानु पर्छ
And he will engage in sex activities only for the purpose of having Krishna conscious children. So in this way the devotee is the perfect, he's the greatest yogi. This is described in the sixth chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Yoginam api sarvesham madgate nantaradmanam shradavan bhajate yomam sameyuta tamo mata. Of all yogis, the highest yogi is the one who is always using his senses in my service and is fully absorbed in me. He's the greatest yogi. So Prahlad Maharaj is not against these other processes which are all mentioned
here.
But he knows that the important thing is to do service for the Lord.
महत्व चाहिँ के हो त भन्दाखेरि भगवानको सेवा गर्नु महत्व एकदम सावधान हुनुपर्छ
बिकज पिपल बिकम भेरी प्राउड वेन दे डु दिस काइन्ड अफ थिङ्स लाइक चान्टिङ मन्त्रास एन्ड ऑस्टेरिटीज एन्ड लिभिङ इन सोलिट्युड
र मान्छेहरू के गर्छन् भन्दाखेरि आफैमा एकदम अहम आउँछ तपस्या गरो जप गरो शास्त्र अध्ययन गरो भने उ आफै आफमा भक्त अहम बन्न सक्छ
दिस प्राइड दिस अहंकार दिस विल कीप अस इन द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड
र यो अहंकारले के हुन्छ त भन्दाखेरि हामीलाई यो भौतिक संसारमा डुबाइदिरहेको हुन्छ
Devotee Krishna does not like his devotees to be proud.
Ra bhaktaru sanga Krishna ununcha ra ti bhaktaru ahankar garnu hudaina.
Lord Chaitanya taught us to think of ourselves lower than the straw in the street.
Ra Chaitanya Mahaprabhu le hamlai shiksha dinuncha ki hamaru jhar bhanda ni ajja nimna hu bhanera tesari hami
To be tolerant, like the tree. Just like the tree tolerates the heat and the cold and the wind and the rain. But the tree gives shelter. The tree provides fruits and it provides flowers. So there are some trees are very pious, they're very great souls. And so we have to learn from the trees how to be tolerant. And we have to offer all respect to others. And not to want respect for ourselves. So in this way, then we can chant properly. Then we can chant with love, with real devotion. Devotional service is not mechanical. Devotional service, we need the mercy of the Lord. So we have to pray to the Lord to please be merciful to us and accept us. So we'll stop here today. Ask if there's any question.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam, Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Prabhu. Mere evada prashna cha, Prabhu.
Hajur.
यो के अरे वैराग्य हाम्रो जीवनमा कति जरुरी छ र जो हामीले भक्तिको साधना गरिन्छ त्योद्वारा वैराग्य आफै आउँछ कि वैराग्यको लागि फेरि भिन्दै कोही साधना भिन्दै कोसिस गर्नुपर्छ
महाराज जी दिस प्रभु इज क्वेशन दैट वैराग्य इज हाउ इम्पोर्टेन्ट इन आवर लाइफ डू वी हैव टू प्रैक्टिस सेपरेटली फ्रॉम डिवोशन और इज हाउ वी हैव टू गेट वैराग्य
Yes, Vairagya follows wherever there is genuine devotion.
Vairagya yadi bhakti kasto bhane ekdam bhakti maharaj ji bataunu genuine devotion bhanesi ekdam gairai ma bhakti bhayo bhane tyo vairagya aafai aap auncha.
Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, chapter 2. Sutta Goswami says, Vasudevi Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojita Jnana Yati Asu Vairagyam Jnanam Chaya Dahitukam. that by doing devotional service, one will naturally, automatically acquire knowledge and detachment.
सुखदेव गोस्वामीले श्रीमद् भागवतम द्वितीय स्कन्दमा बताउनुहुन्छ कि जसले भगवानको भक्ति गर्दछ उसलाई ज्ञान र वैराग्य साथसाथै प्राप्त हुँदछ.
So there are different kinds of vairagya. I explained about markat vairagya, monkey renunciation. So that kind of renunciation, like the monkey, that's useless. And then there's smasana vairagya, renunciation when you go to crematorium.
Crematorium?
It means where they burn the dead body. Right, when you go to see the dead body burned, when you go to your friend's funeral, maybe a friend dies or a relative, then you're feeling very renounced. You're thinking this world is useless, this life has no meaning. But next day you go to movies, you watch cinema, and you're thinking about enjoying material life. So that kind of renunciation, very short lived, not very long. So that is all falgu vairagya, false renunciation. False renunciation also, just like a jnani. The jnani will think, oh, this world is not real, nothing is real. And they, even if they see $100 lying in the street, they'll say, don't touch it, it's maya, just leave it. But proper renunciation is called yukta vairagya, means renunciation in relation to Krishna. Just like if a devotee finds $100 in the street, he will take it and he will donate it to the temple. Because he knows everything belongs to Krishna. So that money also belongs to Krishna, so he will give it to Krishna. That is actual renunciation. You use everything in the service of Krishna. Right? Just like we're using this technology, Zoom. We have our satellite in the air, in the space, and it's broadcasting. And you're in Burma and I'm in India, but we can give class. And this is using technology, and this is renunciation in the service of Krishna. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Prabhupada's guru, He followed Rupa Goswami's principle of renunciation.
Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada ka guru le Rupa Goswami ko siddhanta lai apnaunu bhayeko.
Yeah. He would use a car. He would go to visit big people. He would go in a car.
Ravale sanyasununto tepni gaadi ruma chadara januntyo. Tutula mancherla bhet garna ko lagi.
Other sadhus, they were going barefoot, walking everywhere, but he would go in a car and wear shoes. Because he was using everything in the service of Krishna. So the real wealth of a devotee, the wealth is understood by his knowledge and his renunciation. Knowledge means knowledge of the scriptures. And vairagya, renunciation, it means detachment from material sense gratification. Just like different currencies, there are different currencies. You've got dollar, and you've got baht, and you've got peso. In Burma, you've got chat, right?
Yes. नाना प्रकार का पैसा रे देखिन छ जस्तो प्रकारले डलर बाट चाट रुपी.
So we can say $100 is equal to 100 chat.
हामीले $100 $100 चाट भन्न सकिदैन.
No, why the money all has different values?
किन त पैसाहरुको अलग अलग दाम भएको.
Because the countries, they have different value, they have different gold, amounts of gold in their banks. So in the same way, there are different spiritual processes, there are different paths of faith. And you can understand which one is the best by how much knowledge and renunciation they have. You have to look how much do they really know about God and the kingdom of God. How much they can understand about the mind and the senses, material body. And how much are they detached from sense gratification? Prabhupada used to say, Swami means one who can be in a room with beautiful women and he will not be disturbed.
Swami bhaneko euta kamra ma euta sundari kanya sanga basnu ulai kasale pani disturb nagarnu.
So that is renunciation.
Tyo bairagi.
We see Haridas Thakur, he could chant the holy name and he could make the prostitute into devotee.
Haridas Thakur le bhagwan ko naam jap garnu bhayo ra wahan le vaishya lai pani bhakta banaunu bhayo.
All right. Any other question?
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Pranam.
Ji, Prabhuji, ma Gita ko euta shlok ko vishay ma alikati malai spashta nabhayeko pani. Bhagwan Sri Krishna le 8th adhyay ma Shukla ra Krishna paksha ma parayan garne yo sansar dekhin bhanne bataunu bhayeko cha. Krishna paksha ma parayan hune chahi feri yo sansar ma farkera aunchan. शुक्ल पक्षमा चाहिँ यो संसारलाई छोडेर गएका भगवानको धाम आध्यात्मिक जगतमा पुग्छन् भनेर भन्नुभएको छ तर त्यसमा अनि भक्तहरू पनि यदि कृष्ण पक्षमा उनीहरू गयो भने तिनीहरूको चाहिँ के गति हुन्छ होला भन्ने सोध्छु
महाराज जी प्रभु इज क्वेश्चनिंग दैट कृष्ण पक्ष एन्ड शुक्ल पक्ष हु लेफ्ट द बॉडी इन कृष्ण ऑन टाइम ऑफ कृष्ण पक्ष ही हैवन गो टू धाम ही गो टू हेल And Shukla Paksha, who left the body, he go to Dham of Vaikuntha. How do we understand that somebody left, devotee, left the body in Krishna Paksha? So how do we understand that?
For a devotee, it doesn't matter. For a devotee, there's no question of what's auspicious or what's inauspicious. That's only for people who are not devotees.
Maharaj le yaha utarte bhanuncha, कि भक्तहरुको लागि कुन शुभ हो कुन अशुभ हो मतलब छैन त्यो चाहिँ अभक्तहरुको लागि मात्र शुभ र अशुभ हेर्नु पर्छ भक्तहरुको लागि हमेशा शुभ शुभ
The devotees surrender to Krishna and Krishna takes care of his devotees
र जो भक्तहरु भगवान प्रति शरणागति भएका हुन्छन् ती शरणागति भएका व्यक्तिहरुलाई भगवानले उनीहरुको जिम्मेवारी लिनुहुन्छ
Krishna says, Kunti apriti janahi name bhakta pranashati. Krishna takes care of his devotees, he will not let them perish.
Ra Nyaniri Bhagwanli Bhachandinvacha Arjuna Kunti apriti janahi name bhakta pranashati. Mira bhakta ko kailo binas unena ma under the jimavari linchu vanera. Mira bhakta kailo binas unena china mande vanunja.
Just like it was said, what happens if the devotee dies and somehow he's not able to remember Krishna at the time of death? What will happen? Where will he go? The devotee dedicated his life, whole life, to the service of Krishna, but somehow he may die in some unfortunate situation. Where he cannot chant the holy name or he's not conscious. So what will happen? So Krishna himself answered this, as in the, I think it's the Garuda Purana, where Krishna says that, he said, my devotee cannot remember me, but I will remember him and I will deliver him. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, in chapter 12, Krishna says, I am the swift deliverer from the ocean of birth and death. Krishna is the one who delivers the devotee. We don't deliver ourselves. It's not just because you die at some auspicious time that you'll get delivered. You need Krishna's mercy.
र भगवानले भगवद् गीताको 12 अध्यायमा भन्नुहुन्छ कि मेरा भक्तहरूलाई जन्म मृत्युको चक्रबाट पार गराउने मै हुँ र मालाजी भन्नुहुन्छ कि हामीहरू पार हुने सक्ने हाम्रोसँग कोही क्षमता छैन तर हाम्रो सेवा भगवानले हामीलाई पार गराइदिनुहुन्छ
Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Samoham sarvabhuteshu na me dveshosti ma priya ye bhajanti tu mam bhakta mai te teshu chapyam. Krishna says, I am equal to everyone, but I have a special relationship with my devotee. So Krishna takes care of his devotees and he brings his devotees back to him. We need have no doubt about this. This is very important to understand how Krishna takes care of his devotees.
र यो गुन्नलाई एकदम हामीले ध्यान दिनुपर्छ यो गुन्न पनि अति आवश्यक छ कसरी आफ्ना भक्तलाई भगवानले वापस लिएर जानुहुन्छ भनेर
So there's no question of inauspicious time or auspicious time. For the devotee, this is not important. It's a very material calculation. Devotees on the transcendental platform. So Krishna personally comes and takes care of that devotee, brings him back. Okay, any other question?
Hare Krishna Maharaj Ji, Dhanal Pranam.
Hare Krishna.
Prabhuji, my order person, Jagi Prabhuji. Diksha lena ko lagi, ame apne ko umar ko zarurat tha ki yogyata ko jin zarurat tha.
Prabhuji, this question that Maharaj Ji.
Nahi, hamro 15-16 barsha ma diksha lena huncha ki hunna.
He's 16. For the initiation, is necessary age or qualification? Is necessary?
Is it necessary to get initiation?
Any age, there's a...
Any age? Yeah. Prabhupada said usually it should be at least 14.
बाजीले बताउनु भएछ कि कमसेकम 14 वर्षको चाहिँ हुनु पर्छ दीक्षा लिनको लागि भनेर
shouldn't be too young because we see people when they grow up sometimes their minds change when they're very young they may be quite eager to be devotee but as they grow up they may lose their interest
र यहाँले महाराज बताउनुहुन्छ कि सानामा चाहिँ भक्त हुनको लागि केटाकेटीहरूलाई उत्साह हुन्छ तब जब ठुलो हुँदै जान्छ उनीहरूको मन परिवर्तन हुँदै जान्छ त्यसो भन्दाखेरि 14 वर्षमा चाहिँ दिन हुन्छ त्यहाँबाट निचेलाई दिन हुँदैन
गुरु धारण गरेर बल्ल भगवत धाम जान उद्धार हुने छ भनेर सुन्यो
यहाँ वी आर देयर अन्टिल वी डिडन्ट टेक अ दीक्षा गुरु वी कैन नॉट गेट बैक टू गॉड हेड
Well, I never heard that before. Who said that?
Prabhu is saying that.
No, I've never heard that. But it helps. Certainly, it's a great help. To get the mercy of Krishna, we can't go directly to Krishna on our own. We have to go through the devotees. Right, by the mercy of the spiritual master, you get the mercy of Krishna. If you go directly without the spiritual master, then Krishna will say, where's your guru? Who's your guru? So you should have a spiritual master. Krishna had a spiritual master. Krishna went and got trained by a spiritual master. Lord Chaitanya had a spiritual master, Prabhupada had a spiritual master, why you don't need a spiritual master? Everyone has got a mother and father. Only the fortunate person has got a guru. By the grace of guru, you get Krishna.
Thank you so much, Maharaj Ji. Hare Krishna.
हरे कृष्ण
माताजी तपाईं बोल्दै त सारे सुनिदैन
I can't hear any.
I'm also cannot hear Maharaj ji.
Hare Krishna Maharaj ji bhanu aba alikati majale bhanu ta sunne cha. I think she is Devahuti from Bangkok Guru Maharaj.
Who is it?
Devahuti Maharaj from Bangkok.
Oh Devahuti.
Maharaji, as I understand, I will explain you. She is doing service and she is giving a respect, but they didn't like them. Oh, Mataji.
मैले नमनपराएको होइन एक्चुली के भन्दैछु नि अब कहिले कहिले यसो हुन्छ होइन अलिकति नोकझोक हुन्छ उनीहरूले हामीलाई मन पराउँछ अनि नमन पराएर जस्तो कोही कोही हाम्रो गाह्रो उनीहरूलाई मन पर्दैन अनि त्यसमा किन हामीले उनीहरूलाई सम्मान दिन सक्दैन अनि तिनीहरूको लागि पनि हामीले सम्मान आफ्नो दिनमा कसरी
लामो तपाईँले व्यक्तिगतमा मारेर सोध्नु होला त्यो कुरा चाहिँ मलाई कसरी बुझाउनु त्यत्रो लामो त
हरे कृष्ण मैले बुझ म भन्दिनँ छोटोमा तपाईँलाई सोधिदिने ओके माताजी माताजीले भन्न खोज्नुभएको महाराजले भन्नुभयो नि हामीले सबैलाई सम्मान दिनुपर्छ तर कोही कोही व्यक्तिले चाहिँ हामीले दिएको सम्मानलाई उनीहरूले रुचाउँदैन र त्यसमा हामीले सम्मान दिएन भने हामीलाई अपराध हुन्छ कि के हो भन्ने कुरा होइन माताजी ल त ल ठिक छ लेखेर पठाउनुहोस् माताजी लेखेर फेरि अर्को जो महाराजलाई सोध्नु लेखेर
पठाउनु
अरू कसैलाई सोध्नु छ सोधिहाल्नुहोस्
भयो होला आज धागो धर्म भोलि पनि सोध्नु भन्नु न म जान छ मेरो काम छ
ल ठिक छ ल भन्नु भन्नु
यस महाराजी
भन्नु न अनि
परम पूज्य भक्तिविघ्न विनाश नरसिंह स्वामी महाराज की
जय
श्री प्रभुपाद की
हरे
कृष्ण
महाराज
हरे बोल खेला